So that's it. Then at goalless in Group A of the 20 under 20 AFCON, Nigeria 0, South Africa 0. And you could tell that the players were a bit frustrated at the end of that one because they wanted to win. They played to win. Coach Igbokwum gave them a strategy, tactics to win, but it didn't just happen for them. These South Africans, everywhere we go now, South Africans just come out. When they see Nigeria, they just fold their sleeves and start getting ready for us. But good news, the match between Burundi and Niger ended 3-3. What a story. So the Flying Eagles still on top of the Group A table, but they need to beat Niger in their final group match to at least book a place at the FIFA Under 20 World Cup. Let's talk about it more. Cosmas Chukwuemeka is with us now. Cosmas, good to have you around.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I mean, it's all about the Flying Eagles. Yeah, they're actually doing well. I mean, I have statistics right here.
Okay.
Against the Amajitas of South Africa. Nigeria had 13 shots to their 2 shots. Three shots were on target
okay.
to 1. Nigeria possession 67. To 33. Nigeria completed 485 passes to Diaz,
right.
260 passes. Of course, Nigeria had more fouls. I mean, the fouls were the same thing, 15-15 fouls.
Okay.
They had 2 yellow cards, no red cards, no offside. Nigeria had more corner kicks to 7-1,
yeah.
And Nigeria had 79 pass accuracy to their own 52.
79 pass,
accuracy.
Okay.
So basically, Nigeria did well.
Yeah, so I love the stats that you read out because some persons are really going hard on the team on social media. They're saying that, oh, it's a poor team. They should have done better. So when you tell me that 13 shots are completed, 485 passes, 67 possessions, were they just unlucky today?
I think they were unlucky. I mean, before coming to the studio, I was watching the highlights of the game on YouTube, and I'm sure it's something that probably our producer will probably show later. But for me, I felt that they did their best. I felt that the Flying Eagles had opportunities to have won the game. But you must give kudos to the defense of the Amajitas, South Africa. They did really, really well to push away the Nigerians. At some point, Nigeria were playing short from outside. Couldn't go in. They had situations where the referee was supposed to give some penalty calls, but the referee didn't, and that was why. And there was some bit of a protest for the Flying Eagles against the Amajita. So I felt Nigeria did well, but then it's always difficult at this level to play against the South Africans. I remember 4 years ago,
because
it was difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Nigeria couldn't even win them.
Yeah.
So it's always difficult at this time.
We missed out the last edition, so maybe that's why persons have their expectations pumped up.
Yep.
But let's talk some more. At this level, a lot of these players are not known, but we know Ukwem Utin, and we know his quality.
Yeah.
Nafizi has also shown his quality.
Mm.
Afiz Aremu is also in the team. So when you look at that team and what Coach Paul Igbokwum is trying to achieve with it, is it a team that can go to the World Cup? Because I know Nigerians are not looking at this competition.
They're looking at the World
They are
Cup.
Looking at the World Cup.
Well, I think it's a team that can be able to compete at any level, at any competition. In this level, at any competition. Just a little change here and there. But first of all, before we talk about the World Cup, we need to qualify
That's
for the
right.
World Cup. Because you're playing Niger next. I mean, this is a game. Nigeria had the chances.
Mm.
And you're playing against Niger next. And don't forget, at the WAFU tournament, Niger actually defeated Nigeria in that one. So it's really going to be difficult to say. So for me, I feel that I like the way they pass. I like the interchange of the ball. I like the way on the run of play, the way they do, the way they counter. The way they counter. I mean, you could see the goalkeeper, how he saved the ball. I'm talking about the goalkeeper of the Amajitas. It was a game where Nigeria could have won, but somehow they were clearly better than the South Africans.
Mm.
So as I was saying, this team is a good team that can be able to compete.
I agree.
Well,
I agree.
But they just need a bit of change.
More
and
More learning to play together,
exactly.
Understand themselves, and then we can see more from the team. Let's go on this quick break. When we come back, what can they do? Talking about the Flying Eagles to beat Niger in their final Group A match. And of course, we'll talk about some of the frustrations and the decisions of the referee in that match. So don't go anywhere. Stay with us.
Daily news that brings you events from different states. News across Nigeria.
Welcome back for tonight on China's television. We're taking a look at the under 20 AFCON. It's taking place in Nigeria. Nigeria is in Group A alongside, of course, the host country, Niger Republic, the South Africa, and Burundi. Nigeria started off beating Burundi by 2-0. Today they played a goalless draw with South Africa. Niger and Burundi played 3-3. At the point, I was like, Niger, we win that match and go on top of the group. So the Flying Eagles, they are still on top of the Group A table with 4 points. But they need to win their last match, their final group match against Niger. Let's talk about ways that they can win that match against Niger. I love the attitude I saw against Burundi, going forward, coming back. Yeah. Even when they had just one goal, they kept going forward to look for the second, and they did get it. Someone should not tell me because it's Burundi. At this level, almost everybody is almost equal because you don't have renowned names, those big names that you can use. And look at them against Burundi. You could tell position. Look at that for a starter. They're unfortunate not to go in. You know, so Cosmos, you think they should play the way they played against Burundi?
I mean, basically, that's how they played against the Amagitas today. Same way they attacked, the way they defended. They defended well, they attacked well. They were unlucky just to score. And of course, they met a very disciplined South African defense. But then, they're going to be playing a last game against Niger Republic. And I say Niger Republic are very, very difficult to beat. I'll give you an example. In their game against Burundi today, look at the stats. They actually I'm talking Niger Republic against Burundi.
Okay.
They played 2-0 first. I mean, they had a penalty in the 18th minute and they scored in the 42nd minute. They scored in the 42nd minute and it was like 2-0. But at the stroke of halftime, Burundi actually scored one. Then, of course, in the 56th minute, they scored before Burundi, you know, out of, I don't know, probably luck or whatever, football kind of tech. They scored two goals in 60 seconds.
Woo!
In the 73 and in the 74th minute. So you want to say that and the Nigerians... when it comes to goal scoring, and they're at home again, they can score.
Maybe they were complacent.
That's just it. Now, what the Flying Eagles should do is a very, very simple thing. Keep to the tactics, but at the same time, you need to be very, very aware defensively.
Did they show enough hunger today?
I felt they showed enough hunger. I felt they wanted to win, and they were very unhappy not to win. I mean, look at this goal. Look at this goal. This goal is... world class, if you want to talk about it, the way he dribbled it, and it's, I mean, the awareness, the purpose, and of course, the way he scored the goal was massive as well. I've not particularly seen this goalkeeper.
Yeah.
I don't think he has been tested enough, really. So I think the jury is still out on him.
Okay, let's talk about the outlook of the match today, the referee and the decisions he made. For instance, the final whistle, we'll see pictures now.
Yeah.
The players were protesting. What's your take in all of this?
I felt that...
So ball goes out of play, and he pointed. You see, he actually pointed for the throw-in to come, and then he ends the game.
Well, this happens in football. I do not understand why Nigeria was protesting, but it happens in football. When the time is over... when the time is over, no matter the call of the referee, it ends. This reminds me of last season Nigeria Professional Football League season when FC Fine Yoruba traveled to Kano to play against Kano Pillars. Remember that game? FC Fine Yoruba? Yes,
yeah,
FC Fine Yoruba had a free kick and it was the end of the first half. They had a free kick, it was the end of the first half and the referee blew the free kick and immediately when the guy played the free kick, the referee blew, even when it entered the net. It is in the rule book. And in the rule book, a referee has a discretion to end the game however way he sees fit.
But Nigerian football fans are asking Cosmos that the referees are aware of the time because they were playing 3 minutes of added time.
Okay.
So the referee, when the South African cleared the ball for throwing, at that point should look at his time to be sure. But he directed play to go on. So with Nigeria about to start the attack because... I mean, it's football.
They
could get anything
goal.
Out of it. Mm-hmm. So don't they have a point to prove?
They might have a point to prove, but according to the rules of football, the referee has the discretion to end the match however way he deems fit.
Yeah.
when the match has ended. The least time is 3 minutes. It could as well go. You cannot end the match below 3 minutes. So the can as well go afterwards, but the least time is 3 minutes. And frankly speaking, this player should be giving lots of enlightenment and education.
I agree,
on the rules of football,
at this level.
Particularly at this level. Yeah. Because if we continue to do like this, I mean, it's really going to show, I mean, it's really bad for the country.
That has been a major discussion on social media, and that's why I thought it's important we also discuss it, because the players should have been aware, though they don't have the proper time, you know, but they know that they are deep into the match, and protesting just comes. When you protest, even if you're doing it the right way, so for instance, Uti ran there and was trying to tell the players, calm down.
That's
calm
because
down.
He understands why he plays for Enyimba. He understands why. And the truth is that no matter how it is, CAF will probably have some sort of sanctions against these players or against the officials.
And again,
because
they are young, they shouldn't grow
They shouldn't do this. I think it's something that we should discourage, and we are discouraging it right here on Sports Tonight. We should discourage. It shouldn't happen. And we're not going to say because we're Nigerians we should support this. We're not supporting this. This was wrong in
because
all
I could
levels.
Tell that even when the referee, you know, did this for continuous play, he has an assistant.
He has an assistant.
I would have told him.
Exactly. And there's a fourth official.
Yeah.
And as I said, according to the rule book of FIFA, CAF, in fact, MPFL, the referee has the discretion to end a match.
Okay.
However way he deems fit, provided it is not lower than the allocated time.
It's okay. So that's what it is. Nigeria 0, South Africa 0, Burundi 3, Niger 3. Group A is looking tight, but let's see what the Flying Eagles can do in their final group match. Before we leave this, Ned Blaster says, no doubt it was difficult breaking down South Africa, but the lads have been impressive. Thank you. They have shown the hunger to win. Fortunately, Niger drew, so we are still in the driving seat. It's not going to be an easy one against the host, but I trust the guys to scale through. That's the attitude. Let's keep supporting the team. Tari Aruwe says, they still need cohesion and should not be in a hurry. They can still qualify because that's all they are thinking, qualifying for the World Cup. Akinda Enibolarinwa says, most of these under 20 boys are well above 20 years. We can't develop our football this way. Age grade competition should be for the purpose of development.
So well, we do not have any proof to the fact that they are way above that.
Yeah.
Yes, it's a burn, but we do not have any
but
proof.
But there are different ways you can be promoting age cheat customers. For instance, the win at all cost. When you see people playing in under 17 and under 20, I say they must win because they are wearing the Nigerian jersey. So we put so much pressure, and sometimes, look, in organizing the Channels International Kids Cup, I've come to realize that HE doesn't just even stay with the players.
I agree.
Sometimes
it stays
parents,
with the officials,
the parents. You know, it's deep.
It cuts across.
Us must be ready to. For instance, persons are disappointed, saying that the team is poor. But, so it means that if you have a team that is doing so well,
the coach is on pressure. I do not think Coach Aigbogun is a kind of coach. I feel he's a very disciplined coach.
Yeah.
I've listened to him talk. Very astute coach, very knowledgeable, and he knows his words. I do not think that he's going to try this.
No proof. Let me just run through March Day 7 of the Nigeria Professional Football League if we've got some time. Tomorrow we're monitoring that one. Wiki Tories, we take on Enyimba, Rivers United, we play Kwara United, Remo Stars will go against MFM. Niger Tornadoes, we play Sunshine Stars. Rangers, they will take on Lobi. So this is the two guys in the continent.
Mm.
And they will play themselves tomorrow. Katsina United, we play Bendel Insurance, who just got their first win of the season, beating Lobi Stars. In Group B, go around, we play Kano Pillars. Nasarawa United, we play Plateau United. Kada City, we host El Kanemi Warriors. Abia Warriors, they will be hoping to consolidate after going to FC Fayoba to win, stop their unbeaten run. They will play Heartland, while FC Fayoba will play Gombe United. And you'll beat Desert Stars. We play Aqua United. Customers, we don't have so much time, so I'm just going to say thank you so much for your time. We'll talk more about this next week.
All right.
And of course, to you, wherever you are watching Sports Tonight on Channels Television, thank you so much for your time. Keep talking to us on Twitter, Channels_Sports, Facebook Channels, I think Sports for the team. I'm Austin Okunapan, and everything you do, remember, keep talking sports. Bye for now.